Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video, released today on the 30th of August. Of course, I just took a look at the new Indian main battle tank in the previous episode, released yesterday. But we finally have our very first air dev blog for the next major update. We've seen mostly ground forces and one naval unit. And now we get a plane, and it is the F-16C Block 50. So we're getting a more advanced version of the F-16, I guess. Like hell I would know anything about that. That's what the dev blog is going to have to attempt to explain to me. But let's take a look. So the F-16C Block 50 is a further developed variant of the famous F-16 multi-role fighter, featuring a new engine and new guided weapons. Meet this exciting jet fighter coming to War Thunder in the next major update. It's the F-16C Block 50. It's a jet fighter for the United States of the 8th rank. It features 8 weapon hardpoints, an unfortunate addition of laser-guided bombs, and an improved engine. Here's some history of the unit. And here we've got some screenshots that look actually kind of badass with the way that the lighting is positioned here. The F-16C Block 50 will come to War Thunder in the next major update as a new flagship jet fighter at the top of the United States fighter jet line. So they keep stating U.S. here. It doesn't say anything else about other nations. It doesn't say anything about Israel or, you know, or any other nation getting a crapload of F-16s right off the start. So we'll have to see what that means, because, of course, the biggest concern most people have is whether or not other nations are going to get a counter to this new American jet fighter. I don't know much about that myself, so time will tell on the dev blog if that's actually going to be the case or not. Anyways, featuring 8 weapon hardpoints, a more powerful engine, AIM-7 Sparrow air-to-air missiles, which I'm also being told this plane did not have, meaning that they're kind of actually too weak for this aircraft, but I could be wrong on that. I guess they're probably withholding actual powerful missiles for a later date. And most excitingly, the CAS options. Thanks, person who wrote this dev block. The new laser-guided precision bombs. The F-16C will be a formidable force to be reckoned with. So let's take a look at the details. Courtesy of the Block 15 modernization program, the F-16C is equipped with a brand new F-110 GE-129 engine, which in comparison to the well-known F-16A means that the F-16C will have an increase in thrust and static and lower speeds. Furthermore, when approaching the speed of sound, the thrust increase is proportional to the overall mass of the F-16C. Because of this, while at transonic and supersonic speeds, the performance of the F-16C is equal to or just slightly superior to the F-16A Block 15. What are these fucking blocks? Okay, moving on to what weaponry this further developed F-16C has to offer. Thanks to 8 weapon hardpoints and a new radar, the F-16C will ensure that you'll have the best weapons at your disposal. For air-to-air missiles, the F-16C can carry the AIM-7 Sparrow air-to-air missile, as well as AIM-9L Sidewinders. Okay, maybe I think I was being told about the AIM-9 Sidewinders, not the Sparrow. But in addition to this, the F-16C can also carry conventional unguided weapons that can be used against ground targets, which include free-fall retarded bombs, incendiary bombs, as well as rockets. There is certainly plenty to choose from. There are also exciting new laser-guided bombs, which are currently not featured on F-16s in the game. Thanks to the addition of the Lightning spelled interestingly, 2 targeting pod. Previous F-16 pilots will be glad to know that this means 2 types of bombs, the GBU-12 Paveway 2 and GBU-24 Paveway 3, weighing 500 and 2,000 pounds respectively, will be able to be carried on the F-16C. Moreover, the F-16C can also carry AGM-65D Maverick missiles, which are launched from a triple rail pod. And here we've got some more screenshots of the aircraft. You can see it's air brakes, I assume. I don't know. I'm assuming those are air brakes, but the aircraft have gotten very advanced. And of course, we'd like to mention that our artists, especially for the F-16C Block 50, have prepared a very cool snake camouflage of the Viper Demo Team Aerobatic Team. That's it for now. So this camouflage that you can see in here is actually a special aerobatics team paint scheme, I guess. There, which has got a cool looking like bulldog on it. It almost looks like the one from Tom and Jerry. But anyways, so there you go. Obviously, if you're an aircraft fan, you finally get a dev blog on a plane. But whether or not you were looking forward to a new top tier jet fighter or an American one at that is up to you to decide, of course. That's going to bring this one to an end. I really don't have much to say aside from, I guess, just hoping, like everyone else, that there is at least some sort of new jets for other nations to experience so that we don't have, you know, one nation sitting as top dog for the next major update until the following update. But as for other stuff that's been announced, of course, that was the only plane so far. The only naval force unit that's been announced is the New York-class battleship, the USS Texas BB-35 for United States Blue Water Fleet. And then we have a bunch of ground force units, including the new Russian 2S1, a new mobile artillery vehicle for their tech tree. They're also getting a new premium, the TO-55, which is a T-55 with a flamethrower. Sweden is getting the PVKV-4, a new tank destroyer that finishes off their PVKV series. With a closed-off turret, I think. China is getting a Pakistani and Chinese-designed main battle tank, the MBT-2000, for their tech tree. France is getting the AMX-10M, a new SPG that can fire missiles from its main gun. And, of course, Great Britain is getting a new Indian squadron vehicle, the T-90, an Indian T-90 main battle tank as a squadron unit.